Hello, in this video I'm going to be looking at the Razer Onza Tournament Edition controller for Xbox 360 and PC. This is the predecessor to the Sabertooth, which has just come out and is slightly better, but because of that, you know, it may mean you'll be able to get a better deal on this one. Retails for around 60 to 70 quid, but you might be able to pick one up second hand for 30 to 40 quid, and hopefully I'll be able to have a review of the Sabertooth soon. In the meantime, the Onza, the main features about the Onza is you've got extra shoulder buttons at the top, which sit in front of the standard LB and RB ones. So these are the new ones, and these are your standard ones. And you can basically remap these buttons. So maybe you want to press that button in Halo, and it will reload for you. So you won't be able, you won't have to, you know, you can keep your hands there. You won't have to press X to reload. You can just use that button, for example. You can use that button to jump, for example. And to do that, you simply, at the back of the controller, you've got a couple of buttons here. That's for the right shoulder button. That's for the left one. All you do is, if you want to remap the right one, you hold it in and you press the button you want to map it to, and then you let go. Simple as that. The other main feature about the Onza is you've got these twisty analog sticks. So if you twist it to the right, you tighten it, which will mean it will move slower than before. It's ideal for, you know, if you've got a sniper rifle and you want to be a bit more accurate with aiming. And the same goes for if you twist it to the left, this will loosen it. So, okay, that's as far as I can go on that one. Twisting it to the left will make it move a lot quicker. So, you know, maybe you want your character to move really fast, then that's handy there. Start and select buttons have moved down here, which I'm not a big fan of, to be honest. It takes a little bit of getting used to, but not the end of the world. You've got the triggers at the back, RT and LT, are slightly curved, and I like these. If you're going to be holding the controller like that, let's have a look here so you can see. They've got a lot of sort of like flick to them on the end. Bit of a Marmite thing. I've read a few reviews where people don't really like them, but I'm okay with it. The Onza itself feels quite light. There's no batteries. You've just got a cable. It's a 15mm cable. It's quite sturdy. You know, can handle having some chair wheels forced over it. And so yeah, there's no batteries. You've got a matte black finish, which feels quite nice, to be honest. It's quite smooth, and it's meant to be to stop you know the controller from getting a bit sweaty, and you can lose the grip, so you know you maintain your grip with it. And then you've got the standard AX, B and Y buttons are really quick to press. You know, it's really handy for quick time event sequences in games like Castlevania, for example. And these are also backlit as well, so when you plug it in, there you go, it's backlit. So yeah, that's quite cool. If you own a PC, obviously you'll be able to use the Onza to play computer games as well. All you have to do is download an update and plug the controller into a USB port, and you're ready to go. Obviously it's worth noting that not all games allow controller compatibility as standard. So games like Diablo 3, you'll need to download an extra controller program to use this on the PC. Okay, so they're the sort of main features of the Onza. You've also got a D-pad as well, which obviously it's slightly different to the standard 360 controller. You can feel like you have to push the buttons in quite far to get a response. I've tried it out with fighting games like Street Fighter and wasn't impressed, to be honest. But if you're serious about playing fighting games anyway, you'll be using an arcade stick, so that doesn't really matter. So okay, they're the sort of main features of the Onza. You get some. Let's have a look at the packaging. We get some instructions and some little bits and pieces with the Onza. Let's have a look what's inside. So you've got a quick start guide, which is pretty simple, self-explanatory, shows you how to set it all up. And you've got a certificate of authenticity, if that's your kind of thing. You've got some stickers, which are pretty groovy, and you've got a regulatory compliance information document. Really, really exciting thing there. So that's it, pretty much. I mean, I think for me, I wouldn't use the Onza all the time, because I'm not a pro gamer. I'm not really a hardcore gamer. I'd say, you know, if you're the kind of person that plays Call of Duty Online every day, or Halo, or first person shooter, and having that extra shoulder button and the twisty analog sticks does help. If you're serious about your gaming, you want to be able to reload instantly and press another button instantly without moving your hand around, that can be handy, as is the, you know, tightening the analog sticks and increasing your aiming, that kind of thing. But the price tag doesn't really make it an essential purchase, if I'm being honest. But as I say, the Sabertooth is successor recently launched, so you might be able to get a good deal on this one now. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. For more accessory reviews, tips, guides and videos, head over to leakgamesblog.com.